Hi, I'm Julie from Igalia. I'll talk about tasks we handle in MPRs. If you take a look at the history in Chromium in the last 1 year, it's not hard to find some changes with the MPR stack. And there are several talks about MPRs in the last 2 blinkos. For more information about MPRs, please take a look at them first. In this talk, I will not talk about the MPRs concept or details since there are several talks already. I will just simply share what MPRs means here. MPRs means multiple page architecture, and literally it makes to be able to host multiple pages in a single web content. With MPRs, we should review the current code, even though they already work properly and correctly as expected. In order to simply understand why we should do, I brought some example about manifest. Previously, updating manifest worked like this step. Blink recognized that the manifest is updated and it calls module interface to the browser. Once the browser gets the notification, it sends the notification to all observers. After MPRs, it's been changed like after the browser gets the notification, it checks if the document is active or not. Since the only primary document is active, if the page is in pre-rendering, it only returns and skips sending notification. After that, when the pre-rendered page is activated, it handles manifest. We also review the code that accesses the mainframe through web contents. As you can see, it was not weird to use get mainframe through web contents before, but after MPRs, the code needs to access the frame it is targeting like below. If the code aims to access the primary mainframe intentionally, it will be fine. Otherwise, what happens if we still use get mainframe? Let's just imagine that if did finish navigation is triggered by pre-rendering, then the code will work with the wrong target. There are many methods we could use from web contents observer. Among them, did finish navigation is one of the methods we are using when we check something for related UI. In that method, if we also check primary same document committed, primary page changes would be preferred. We also frequently use web content user data when we want to store something related to per-tab data. With MPRs, some places might be using it to store per-page data. There are several options we could choose instead of it. First, navigation handle user data. It stores data for an in-progress navigation. Second, document user data. It approximates the lifetime of a single blink document. Last, page user data. It is attached to the page instead of any document. Thanks for listening.